have a thick mat, but there will be a point where we're on our knees if you want a blanket for that. I'm not planning on using any other props other than a bolster for maybe the end. And for sitting, I'll talk to you about our theme today. So namaste. Thank you guys for being here. I started the chakra series a couple weeks ago. This week's about the third chakra. The third chakra is the solar plexus. So it's the things between, or the place that it governs rather, is between the navel and the sternum. So anything in the midsection of the body, think about the organs that lie here, mostly the digestive organs. And so when we think of the third chakra, it's not just about the digestive tract taking, assimilating, consuming, digesting the food that we eat to send us fuel and energy to keep our bodies healthy and going. But it's also about how well are we consuming, digesting, and assimilating life experiences or what's happening on the outside. So this has been a hard road that we've been traveling. And, you know, when we get stressed out, we tend to gain a little weight here. This is where I gained my pandemic weight, is all through here. And it's represented by the color yellow. The element is fire. And so when we look at fire and yoga, we look at what's called Agni. Agni is the Sanskrit term for fire. It's the inner digestive fire. But beyond that, it's the inner fire transformation. So it's also called the indwelling place of the sun, where we can build internal heat. But it's also the seat of the ego. We talked about the first chakra being more tribal and physical identity, and the second chakra being more sexual identity and emotional identity. And then move up to the third chakra, and it's about our ego identity or our personality. So the personality and the ego can give us drive. So some of the things that are positive about the center, it gives us motivation. It gives us the will to act on what we believe in or to take action towards our goals that we want to attain. It's about confidence and self-esteem. It's our personal place of power, willpower. And it's also concerning not just willpower and confidence, but how well we know ourselves and whether or not we are allowing ourselves to feel empowered or if we tend to become disempowered. When there's excessive or deficient energy in this area, it creates an imbalance. The imbalance can lead to ulcers in the stomach. It can lead to acid reflux. Any type of digestive disorders are usually a result of an imbalanced third chakra. Even organ diseases in this area, it's all third chakra related. So we're going to work, obviously, into the third chakra today. I'm going to do it differently than I've done it in the past. In the past, we've done a lot of cheetahs and a lot of crunches, right, to really work this section and develop some strength. And we've also focused a lot on twist in the past, and we will have a couple twists in this practice. That's saving the twist for Wednesday. That's going to be where we're taking it for Wednesday. I thought for today we'd work a little bit more on the Uddiyana Bandha, the zipping up action that we do to create this elongation in the belly, which activates the transverse abdominis muscles that fan across the belly. The crunches work the rectus abdominis muscles, and then the twist obviously work them all, even the side obliques. So I didn't want to do a lot of crunches today, basically, what I'm trying to tell you. So the addiction that can happen here is eating addictions, but it's all like a bulimia. Think about bulimia. You're going to feed yourself a lot because of emotions or feeling lack or low self-esteem, and then they purge, throw it all up. You know, so that can be a real bad malfunction of the third chakra. But the other addiction that can come about is amphetamines, caffeine, and cocaine. Think about that though. Cocaine, caffeine, right? It's like it's a stimulant, it's speed, it gets you, you know, it wants you to go, go, go. It, you know, it gives you that kind of drive. So that's where it comes into the third chakra. So if you know anyone that's dealing with this type of addiction, it's usually a third chakra related issue. So this is why it's important to understand what it governs physically in the body, but also the psychological components, the spiritual components. There's life lessons to learn from the third chakra. I didn't want to say what chakra I was teaching this week because I was praying people would show. Because no one really likes the third chakra. Everybody loves all the others, right? So let's start on our backs. Now you can have your legs, well, let's just straighten the legs. Let's see if our back will allow that. So extend out through the back of your legs, flex through your heels. And flex the feet so much that they actually levitate away from the floor. And notice how that ignites the knees and the quads, bringing a little energization and fire down below. And then relax that activity so your heels go back down to the mat. And your toes can soften. I'd like you to place your hands on your upper belly. This region between the navel and your base ribs. Close your eyes, spread out your elbows so that your upper back can spread out as well. And when you close your eyes, I want you to start some deep diaphragmatic breaths. So if you have your hands resting right up underneath your rib cage, this expansion and contraction that you're experiencing actually stems from this dome-like muscle called the diaphragm. There's a law in the universe that says everything that expands must also contract. We can notice this even exists in our own body. Continue to breathe in and out through the nose. Let your belly swell on the inhale. Relax on the exhale. I want you to recognize that along with this being the solar plexus, it's also a place where we experience gut instincts. We feel our intuition here. And the seed mantra for this energy center is Ram. Ram. Spelled like Ram, R-A-M. As you continue to breathe in and out through the nose, feeling this movement here in your core, picture it a glow as radiant as the sun. Ever wanting to use crystals to work with the chakra, basically you would pick a stone that has a yellow tone. It could be amber, it could be yellow citrine, yellow topaz, and there's others. You wanted to use essential oils to enhance this chakra. It would be lemongrass, ylang ylang, cedarwood, chamomile, even drinking some chamomile tea. So let's go ahead and inhale, start to bend your knees. And when you bend your knees, we're gonna start that little rolling back and forth with the pelvis.
And you can allow your hands to fall away by the wayside. That's okay. We're going to start to inhale, pick up your low back. As you roll the pelvis forward towards your sits bones. And as you exhale, press into the soles of the feet, elongate your tailbone towards your heels, and feel your abdomen engage and kind of flatten down. And then inhale, rolling towards six, towards the pubic bone. And then exhale, using that Uddiyana Bandha at the belly. And just work this way back and forth, just slowly maneuvering that little minor cat-cow through your hips and pelvis. Do one more. Now we're gonna start to go around the clock. Let's go counterclockwise first. So as you inhale, roll towards six. And then as you exhale, draw it over towards your left side. Inhale, draw the navel up towards the heart, flatten the low back up to 12. And then as you exhale, contract and roll towards the right side of the abdominal wall. Inhale, rolling back to six. It's very meticulous work. And then draw in through your left side of the abs. Inhale, that Uddiyana Bandha up at 12. And then exhale, crossing it over to the right. Let's do that one more. Roll into six, to three, to 12, into nine. To six, now clockwise, over to the right to nine, up to 12 and then eight, and to the left to three. Forward to six, right to nine, up to 12, and three to the left. Do one more. Now, after you complete that, hug your knees in. Roll to one side of your body and come up to take a seat. We're going to do some more pranayama. I'm going to sit on my bolster, but if you don't have one, you don't have to sit on one. We're going to do two different types of pranayama here. One is going to be breath of fire. So breath of fire, Kalabhati breath, your hands are going to come alongside your belly button. And you're pulling the navel straight in towards the spine so you can express the air out through the nose. And then you're inhaling, not under control, the breath will come naturally. It's all about a forced, sharp, and short exhalation like this. Let's begin. Sit up nice and tall, hands to the belly. Three, two, one, let it go. Circle the arms up overhead. Place your palms together, going into Parvottasana, seated down pose. Splay the elbows wide. Notice how that opens up your chest. Take a deep inhale in through your nose. Draw the navel in and up to 12. Hold and retain at the top. And then exhale, breathe it out. Again, inhaling. Drawing the navel in and up towards the heart. Retain and hold the breath briefly. And then let it go. One more. release. Bring the hands back down to the belly. Another round of breath of fire. You're ready. Find your own cadence with your breath. Three, two, one. Release. Inhale, circle the arms up overhead, coming back to Parvottasana, seated mountain pose. Same pranayama we did before in this position. Deep breath in. You're engaging the core, trying to pull the energy to trap it at the heart center, and now release. Twice more. Last one. Hands back to the belly. This is our last round of pranayama. You ready for the breath of fire? Find your own cadence. It can be short or rapid. Not that you're ever going to find yourself in this situation, but if it's ever like cold and wintry and you break down and you're having to wait and you don't have heat, this is a breath you should turn to because it can heat the temperature of the body. All right, release. Circle the arms up overhead. Palms together overhead. Deep breath in through the nose. Hold and retain the breath at the top. Release. Twice more. Last one on your own. This time you're gonna bring the arms down. I'm gonna move the bolster away because what we're gonna do next, you kind of wanna be more on flat ground, but blanket's okay, that will work. If your hands are resting on your knees, actually we've been sitting this way a while for the pranayama. Let's swap the position of the feet to even out the hips. And we're gonna do that Kriya, but instead of doing the Kriya where we're dipping down, we're actually gonna add in kind of these barrel rolls with the chest and with the ribs. So start to roll forward, slide it off to one side, and then pull it back to round it out. It's almost like you're trying to add in cat-cow. So think about cow when you come forward to the center, and a little bit of a cat stretch as you round it back. It's very similar to working around the clock that we did earlier. Then reverse that flow. Circling this one way before the other. And I want you to really focus on your third chakra, the area above the navel and your mid back. So we often think about low back issues being, you know, first, second chakra related. The mid back could be third and fourth chakra related. Upper back, fourth, and fifth. All right. Beautiful, last one. And take a moment just to sit and flip your palms open. And just go inside, especially to this region of your body. Send it some attention and love. maybe even imagine that you're stoking that inner fire and the flames are beginning to build. Once you open up your eyes, you're going to separate your feet and lift your hips off the floor, coming into malasana, your squat position. So I take my feet almost to the edges of the mat, heels turn in, toes turn out. And I know that when you're in this position, you may be thinking, oh, second chakra is the hips. It's actually really good for the first chakra because of what's happening with the legs and the feet and the fact that we're so close to the ground. Yes, it's good for the second chakra because it's good for the hips and it's the natural position to be in for childbirth. But I want you to think how this relates to the third. So I said the digestive issues are showing an imbalance in the third chakra. That includes IBS symptoms, diarrhea, and constipation. Okay? So this is a pose that can be very medicinal if, in fact, you are dealing with constipation.
It's something else to remember.
Then place your hands down to the floor. We're going to spin the heels back behind the toes and straighten out the legs and bow the head. Now, hello, hamstrings. This pose is really good for the first and second. And then we're going to come back to the squat, turning the heels in, returning to malasana. And then we're going to start to go a little bit quicker, turning the heels right behind the toes on the inhale. Returning to squat on the exhale. And we're just going to continue this sequence. Inhale, straighten the legs as you fold over. And exhale, returning to flex knees. Two more. In your execution, there's no rush at all. In fact, we want to become masterful of the breath. If we learn how to really master and control the breath becomes longer because we have a better capacity with our lungs. Now, when you straighten your legs and fold over, remain here this time. And then activate your feet by plugging them down into the ground and straightening out through the legs and relaxing the elbows that you can gravitate the head a little lower. Explore longer, deeper exhalation in the process to promote that apana energy. And then we're gonna heel toe the feet towards each other. Now, when they come towards each other, let your heels touch and your toes turn out like you're a dancer, okay? So once the toes turn out and the heels tap together, elevate your heels off the floor. You're gonna feel your calves kind of fire up there. Keep on your fingertips. This is where you could potentially move blocks, but we're gonna exhale, bend the knees, drop the tailbone towards the feet and lift the head up. Okay, good. That's our new flow. Inhale, keep the heels levitating away from the floor. And then exhale, come back. Good, continue that. This is the Kundalini version of frog pose. Let's do two more. On this last one, when you come back down towards the floor, stay stationed here. Walk your hands out in front of you. Elongate through the arms, stretch out through the vertebrae. When we circle the arms around behind the feet and about over or balance with an arm bind, that's another variation. It can be a firefly prep. It can also turn into garland pose. We're staying here just to warm up the arms, the shoulders, the upper back. One more deep breath. Now travel the hands back towards your feet. Turn your toes to face the front of your mat. Land your heels to the floor and roll down to a regular uttanasana. So we've been trying to warm up the hamstrings. Hopefully this is not a shock to your system now, even though it gets a little bit more intense the closer the feet are. Let your head relax, loosen your neck. And then on your next in-breath, bend your knees, lift your arms up, Utkatasana, chair pose. When you come to chair pose, glide your thigh bones back. And then elongate your side waist, lift up through your side lats. That will not only elongate the spine, it will shift your weight to become more evenly distributed in the feet, but I want you to notice what happens to the solar plexus. So if you're focusing on lengthening that way, you don't have to necessarily use a lot of effort with your Uddiyana Bandha. Exhale, flow down, Uttanasana. Release the hands up hard as you bow. Inhale, come halfway up. Look out with your eyes. Exhale to Chaturanga Dandasana, stepping the feet back, immediately lowering down so we're not holding plank. Inhale, rise. Upward facing dog. Exhale, come down to your belly. Hover your face. Lift your legs and feet. All right, we're going to be like a seesaw here. So on the exhale, we're going to come down to the brow, keeping the legs and feet up in the air. As we inhale, you can press lightly into your hands, lower the legs and feet, keep your glutes engaged, lift your head and chest. Exhale, tip forward, coming back to the brow, elongating, lifting the legs and feet. And then inhale, coming back up. Good. Exhale, tip forward to the brow. Inhale, coming back up. Now shift to tabletop position. When you shift to tabletop position, you may have to walk your hands back to be a little bit more stationed around your shoulders, curl your toes. Notice how your belly may want to sag. So use your Uddiyana Bandha. So it's just the same action you were doing when you were pushing your feet into the floor and feeling your core really fire up. Get strong in this tabletop position, and then we're gonna hover the knees. The arms are strong like columns. Try not to give out in your core. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, you're coming forward to hover the knees. And then you continue to breathe here. Try not to lower the head too much. Keep the neck in line with your spine. It's hard to talk the core work. And then exhale, downward facing dog. One more of those. Drop down and hover your knees. Exhaling, Adho Mukha Svanasana. All right, this time you're inhaling, stepping your left foot forward in between your hands. Turn and plant your back foot, and you're coming up to warrior one. Keep the shin perpendicular to the floor. Roll your right hip around and face the front. Twirl the kind of pinkies in towards each other. Round those feet. But warrior poses are about confidence and courage. Third chakra set. Are you even engaging your third chakra? Try to do the zipping up action through the belly, that Uddiyana Bandha, and notice how it engages the right side of your glutes. And then as you exhale, open your arms, hang back. Inhale, straighten up, zip up through your midline. Exhale, hang back. One more. Inhale up. Exhale, hands down. Step back plank. Exhale, Chaturanga. Inhale up, we're facing dog.
stretch through the belly. Exhale, come down to the pubic bone. Lift your legs and feet. All right, this time the hands are gonna float and hover. Exhale, tip forward to the brow. Keep the legs up, up, up. Inhale, lower the legs and feet. Keep your glutes engaged. Lift your head and arms. Exhale, tip forward. Keep hovering your hands. Inhale, notice you may not lift as high because you haven't depended on your back at this point. All right, one more. Inhale, when you come up, hands down, shift back, tabletop. So we think back bends with that previous sequence, but it actually is core work as well. Draw the navel in, curl the toes under. I hope you like this core work better than crunches.
Cover your knees.
This is what Holly used to do all the time. I remember when I'd go to Holly's class, she was always doing the hover the knees thing. All right, exhale, downward facing dog. Good, inhale, hover the knees. Continue to breathe. Those are activating core a little longer. All right, exhale, down dog. One more set. Exhale, take it back. Inhale, right foot steps through. Back heel's gonna plant down. Inhale, once you have that firm foundation, come on up. Warrior one. Plant the feet. Stabilize the legs. Activate your core. Exhale, hang back. Inhale, warrior one. Arms frame the face. Exhale, winged arms, hang back. Last one, inhaling up. Exhale back. Inhale, Virabhadrasana. Exhale, hands down. All right, let's go ahead and step the back foot forward. Open up your heart center, look out with your eyes, and exhale, gently release. Inhale, Utkatasana, chair. Side one, shift back. And then elongate your side body, lift through your floating ribs. That will naturally engage your Uddiyana. The purpose of these bandhas is to promote the energy to move upstream. Exhale, hands together, humbly fold. Inhale, halfway up, Ardha Uttanasana. Exhale, take Chaturanga Dandasana, stepping back, shifting forward, lowering. Inhale to Up Dog. Exhale, come on down. All right, this time we're gonna hover the hands like we did in that second round of the last sun out. Come down to the brow as you breathe out. Bring the feet down, head up as you breathe in. Continue rocking slowly. Back and forth. The next time the legs come down, plant your palms, work it back to tabletop. Curl the toes. Make sure your core is included. Important piece as you hover the knees. I'll try not to sway your back. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, come forward, hover your knees. Use your hands here, nice grip. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, hovering table. So the more you kind of drill down through your hands and your feet, it's going to help to engage the core. Exhale, downward facing dog. All right, this time we're going to step the left foot forward and up between the hands. Offset your right foot, pull it down. You're returning to Virabhadrasana 1.
But notice how when we come into the pose, we tend to leave this out. So it takes mindfulness to work from the feet up into the hands. Mindfulness to work from the base and up through the other chakras. Direct your energy there. And then we're going to exalt the warrior. Circle the hands behind you. Lace them together. Pop open the door of your heart. Exhale, hinge to the inside of the front knee. Bow your head. Tip the knuckles up, up, up. Breathe. Inhale, bring it back to warrior one. Exhale, hands are going to frame the front foot. This time, spin away from the back heel. Take it into flying plank. So you don't want to lift that left leg too much. Otherwise, you're going to sway back. So stretch the left foot towards the wall behind you. Shift forward, flowing down to flying chaturanga. Land the tops of the feet. Grow tall into up dog. Exhale, come down to the belly. All right, we're going to take the hands back. Palms down. We're going to change it up a little differently. Lift your legs, locust. Exhale, rock forward to the brow. You guys know what to do. I'm losing my breath talking. The next time you come up, replace the hands under the shoulders. Rock up to tabletop position. Stack the hands below the shoulders, curl the toes. Engage the belly. Hover your knees. Exhale, flare the hips up and back down, release the dog. Inhale, come forward, hover your knees. Exhale, downward facing dog. One more of those, drop and hover. When you're ready, take it back up, straighten out through your legs, press back away from your hands. And on your next inhalation, the right foot's gonna step forward. And the back heel is gonna lower down. Stabilize that front knee by rooting down through the mount of the big toe, climbing up to warrior. Stacking head over heart, heart over pelvis. Engage your bandhas. The diaphragm and the pelvic floor works with the diaphragm here in the belly. Exhale, humble the warrior. Hands behind us first. Lace up and then open the chest. Exhale, descend. Drop the head, gaze straight to the back of your mat. Inhale, warrior one. Exhale, bring the hands down. Spin away from the back heel. Take it into flying plank. Down to flying chaturanga. Land both feet. Stretch the belly, open the chest. And then exhale, come down. So I'm gonna let you choose. Hands down and back, or hover, your choice. Lift your legs. Exhale, lower the head. Inhale, rock it up. Exhale, roll it down. One more. Inhale, this time we land the feet. We're gonna shift back, draw the knees and thighs together, sit back towards your heels, circle the arms around you, spilling over to child. legs are closer together this way. This is better for digestion. So we mentioned last week, this pose is good for the second chakra because it's a forward fold. We're hinging from the hips. This is also a great one for the third eye because it's a slight inversion and we're pinpointing the pressure at the brow. It's also good for the third chakra. When we have this compression and when we're breathing with depth, to massage those inner organs. Inhale, let's stretch the arms forward and out. It's also good for menstrual cramping, abdominal pain or pressure, too much gas. Rock up to hands and knees, all that third chakra issues. Good, curl the toes, lift up and back down our facing dog. So what we're gonna do here is really get established in your palms. Stay strong in your arms, bend your knees, lift your face, look out towards your hands. When you're ready, get a little buoyancy here in the hips, and you have to contract the core in order to land ever so lightly, feet at the top of the mat. Straighten your legs upon arrival, take Uttanasana. Inhale to Utkatasana chair. Make some hands to heart shape your legs. All right, we're gonna face this direction and step to the right. I can't get all the frame. So if you wanna turn towards us, you can, Barbara. Otherwise, it's just a twist. Take a wider stance with your legs and feet. All right, once you have the proper alignment here and the lift through the quads, you're gonna fold forward and drape the hands below your shoulders as you extend out through the spine. So we're not walking the hands back like we sometimes do. All right, inhale. We're gonna sweep the right arm out and up. So twists are obviously excellent for the third chakra. They're also good for all the others as well. Primarily third. Exhale, bring the right hand down. Inhale, sweep it to the other side. Hold and breathe and release. I want you to step the hands halfway from this point to the right foot. And then once you're there, inhale, keep the spine long, twist open to the right again. It's gonna be a little bit different. Your upper body's angling towards the right foot. Good, exhale, bring the hand down. Establish your hands at the center. And then walk it halfway between that point and your left foot and take the left arm out and up. This keeps deepening the twist. Exhale, take it down. This time, walk your hands all the way towards the right foot or as best you can. And then sweep the right arm out and up. Beautiful. Exhale, bring the hand down, take it all the way over to the left foot. When you're ready. I learned this sequence from Rod Stryker, except we were ohming the whole time. Exhale, bring the hand down. Good, once you come back here, heel toe the feet towards each other. Until they're about the same distance apart as squats, what we did earlier. Yep, and then keep your knees bent, bring the arms up. Victory squat, we call it Kali Bhas. Keep your elbows as high as your shoulders. And then try to stabilize your lower body. I don't wanna see the hips or the knees wobble. We're moving from the waist up. Twisting from one side to the other. And you can go at any pace, but the faster you go, the more you start to lose awareness of your foundation. So I find we can do it a little bit better technique to go a little slower. Good. Now release your arms, come back to center, straighten your legs, turn your left foot to the front of the mat and step it up to the top. We're gonna bring it back down. Lift your arms, lift your heels. Come down towards toe balance. No snap, crackle, pop today.
I just got one.
You got one? Bring the hands down and safely come down yourself. The feet are going to be more ahead of your hips, so not actually aligned under your knees, much further up. And we're going to do a little core work here. So inhale, lift your arms up. Exhale, pull the belly straight back. And you're rolling back, tipping the tailbone. Only come like halfway down. And then inhale, draw yourself all the way up. Exhale, pull back. Inhale, forward and up. Exhale, down and back. Do two more. And we're going to switch it up with twist to get the side obliques. Inhale up to the top. Exhale, we take the arms to the left. You contract the left side of your abdominals, like we did earlier on our back when we were going around the clock. Good. Inhale to the top, turn to face the front. Exhale, you're going to drop the arms to the right. Contract the right side of your abdominal wall. Good. Inhale up. Continue this work. Feel free to use Ujjayi breath with this. I find it helps. One more to each side. Slow doesn't always mean easy. All right, inhale back to the top. You feel me? Flip a hold to the back side of your hips. Lift your feet. Flex them. Shoulders back, chest up. Engage that core. And see if you can release your hands. If you want another variation, take it. All right, stretch the legs out. This one you've done with me before. So it looks like this. I'll just give you an example. This is the inhale. This is the exhale. And I want you to wait until your hands and head are safely down to pike your legs and to roll to plow. Holding plow for a breath or more. Contract your core. Roll it down. Only until your sacrum and buttocks touches should you start to lower the legs and lift back up to active dandasana. And we're not gonna fold forward today. We're just gonna stick with third chakra. So starting here, palms open. Think about when you're scooping a fresh scoop of ice cream out of a tub that you just bought from the grocery store. That's what you're trying to mimic here in your core. So scoop out the ice cream at your belly, at your navel center. Good, roll it back. Wait, take your time until your hands and head are back. Pipe the legs. Balasana. Get another scoop of ice cream and roll it down. When your sacrum touches, it's not time to come up. It's when your buttock starts to land, then you can rise. Arms down, scoop it in, and lift back. Hands down, head down, pipe the legs, take the immersion. Breathe here. scoop out some more ice cream and roll it down. Now you're going to be craving ice cream. I shouldn't say that. Now hold, because now we're going to start to cool down, and a forward fold is cooling. You know, Magnus Maggie knows. They had, you know, it used to be at Cool Springs, they had red velvet, and you could put chocolate chips in it. It's divine. Have you ever had Graters?
No.
It's based in Ohio. It's still in Kroger. It's so good. It's blackberry chocolate chip. Or black raspberry chocolate chip. Anyway, something like that.
To be inspired today, and I
what did you say?
I said I came to be inspired today. A bowl of coffee, buzz, buzz.
All right, gently come up. All right, we're gonna roll it back one more time. This is where we're going to spill down and out for Shavasana. So take your time getting settled. I want to play a particular mantra in just a moment. So this mantra I'm getting ready to play, Ramaya, is about invoking more joy. And I want you to think about how third chakra is depicted by the color yellow. And the color yellow in color therapy is about happiness and joy. We're going to start playing that mantra. Before the mantra begins, I want you to meditate on the fire inside. I want you to imagine that this big transformational fire is a blaze, like a bonfire. And I want you to imagine that you're throwing in anything that angers you into the fire. Because anger is the counterforce or the demon, so to speak, of this center. And then I want you to visualize anything that you no longer need, that may be stunning your growth, any limiting beliefs, any misperceptions are also being thrown into the fire. Send all your toxins and impurities from your mind and body into the fire to create inner alchemy so that you can be like a phoenix rising from the ashes to be your best self. And then affirm internally, I am enough. I am confident. I am enough and confident. And affirm in turn, I am strong, I am resilient. I'm strong, resilient. Now I'll turn up the mantra so you can listen, absorb, and consider invoking some joy. It's radiance, yellow light at your center. Bye.
smell the mindfulness badge on. Open up your breath. Take your hands to rest on your belly again and take 3 diaphragmatic breaths. Remember, when we're stressed, we breathe shallow. So this type of breath helps us to de-stress. We'll keep the chakra in check and in balance. For deep breaths like this that come down to the core can also help digestion. On your next inhale, stretch the arms overhead. As you exhale, hug the knees into your belly, rock from side to side. Turning over to your favorite, coming up to take a seat. So continue with third chakra and the rest of the week. Wednesday, we'll focus more on the twist. Now, go ahead and bring your hands to prayer position at your heart. Let's chant Ram together once. Take a deep breath in. Ram. Light within me honors and bows respectfully to that which is inside of you. And we all walk away from this practice joyful and radiant like the sun. Namaste. Cool. See you guys for joining today.